Hello, hello, people who have been gone. Today's notes is a nice just four definitions. Nothing else besides an assignment. So what you're going to do today is you're going to pause the video and write out the 1.3 notes for 9:20. Just copy these down and then unpause and we'll talk about it and catch you up. So you should be pausing right now. Actually pause. Don't just wait me out. Anton, Chris, actually pause the video. Okay, I'm going to assume you did. Hoping you have. I'm going to take the doubt out of my voice now and turn it into, yes, you definitely did this. Okay, so a confounding variable is when you have multiple influences and you aren't sure what caused the effect. Normally in an experiment, you want one thing to change so that you know that that thing that changed is the thing that contributed to the change you're seeing as a result. And you have a control group, so you can kind of weigh it against the effect of having nothing change, but perhaps thinking that you are like a placebo effect. The example I used in class was if you are trying to see if a new display at the end of an aisle will sell more umbrellas. So you make a display at the end of an aisle in a store to sell more umbrellas today, and you're going to see if it works. And then also that day you have a rainstorm and you definitely sell more umbrellas. The question is, what caused the selling more umbrellas? Was it the location in the store, or was it the rain, or was it both? Rain is a unpredicted confounding variable. It's something that came in at the last second and now you're not sure what's going on. This is unexpected. You try to avoid these. Blinding is when participants aren't aware who's getting a placebo. A placebo is a sugar pill. And that is something where people think that they're getting a medication and they are actually getting, a pill, but the pill doesn't have any active ingredients in it. It's just something to see if just the fact that, because sometimes if somebody just takes a pill, they believe that they're going to get better, and just the process of that psychological belief means that they actually will improve. The brain is a powerful thing, and it affects people that way. So you have to give people sometimes that. That's what the placebo effect is. It's when your brain affects you, not the treatment. So you believe that you're getting better, and therefore you do. This especially works with mental illness. Not as much physical illness, but actually still some physical illnesses will be affected by the placebo effect as well. It's an important thing to try out, because sometimes people will think a pill definitely works, and it turns out it definitely doesn't. It was just the placebo effect. Double blinding is when the researchers and the participants don't know who's getting what treatment. What happens there is that sometimes the researchers inadvertently, they're not trying to affect the results, but because they expect the results will be happening a certain way, they decide that they treat the participants slightly differently than they would otherwise. This can be just by the tone and how they ask a question or how they're interpreting the person's response. So, like, for example, let's say we're giving a pill for depression, and the participant who got the placebo, they say, "Are you feeling better?" And the person says, "Yeah, a little." And they are like, "Oh, just a little? Okay, interesting." And then if they had the actual pill and they say, "How are you feeling?" And the participant says, "I'm feeling a little better." They said the exact same thing, but maybe the researcher's like, "Oh, a little better. Good job." And they might rate them higher just because they're hoping, they're expecting that this pill is working. And not trying to fudge the results necessarily, not trying to be a bad person, but interpreting it in a different way. Your homework is this is a pseudo-random number generator that I made. We talked about randomization in class and how it is impossible for human beings to be truly random. We create programs on computers and calculators and so on to try to simulate randomization, which is actually a pretty big, important field, especially in banking and any kind of money situation where you're trying to keep your information private and protected. So you're going to have to go through this on your own. I'm going to attach this file on Schoology, and it is basically just Taking you through a pseudo-random number generator, which will give you a fake random number. And then your homework is on the very bottom, which is to create directions for your own pseudo-random number generator for, and we're going to switch them when we get back together on Thursday. So try to do this on your own. That's the homework, and that's all you missed in class on Tuesday. Okay.